Previously on The Walking Dead.
Shut up, Carly! I've heard enough out of you!
Now, what the fuck's the problem?
You're not coming with us.
I don't know much about you folks, but I can tell you as sure as the sun's gonna come up tomorrow, if y'all keep going on like this, and that girl ain't gonna make it.
What do we do? You're his dad. You gotta do this. Just put an end to it, man.
We need to help find a boat. It's our best bet at safety.
Okay, but we'll be in Savannah, and my parents were in Savannah.
Okay, we'll look for them.
I was the one giving the bandits supplies.
What?
It's all my fault.
We gotta jump!
What? No way!
Can't wait for you to get to Savannah, Clementine. I got your parents right here, and you be sure to find me, whether Lee wants you to or not. Now, what I need...
Who the fuck?
I don't know, but I doubt we're gonna be happy when we find out.
Just for a little while. We're getting real close to where my mom and dad are. Maybe I can...
Not now. I need you to focus. Keep your attention on the street.
Okay. Sorry.
How's Omid?
His leg's pretty bad.
I'm fine.
You're not fine. You need to rest. He needs to rest.
Kenny, how much farther to the riverfront?
There should be just a few more blocks up ahead.
And there'll be boats there?
Sure as hell better be.
There'll be boats. Have to be. Have to be. It's going to be okay. Kenny knows what he's doing. What the hell?
Maybe this city's not so dead after all.
Keep moving. No one's ringing that bell. It's automatic. On a timer.
What kind of church bell goes off at 20 past the hour? Someone's up there!
Are you sure? I don't see anything.
If I were you, I'd get out of the street now.
I thought you said that thing didn't work.
Who the hell is this?
Hello? Hello?
I said answer me!
Was that? Is someone trying to fuck with us?
Sounded more like a warning.
Ask not for whom the bell tolls.
What are you yammering on about?
It tolls for thee.
I
Everybody, run!
Too close, don't you think?
Ben!
No! Ben, help her! God damn it!
Move your asses! River Street's right up ahead!
That's not all.
Oh, give me a fucking break!
Wait, where the hell's Chuck?
Shit, he's in trouble. We gotta help him.
There's no time. We gotta go, now!
I'll be fine. Just go!
I'll get the door.
You okay?
Yeah.
You've opened up your wound. You're bleeding. Shit, it's gonna get infected. We've gotta get him inside. Clean him up.
Kenny, how's that door coming?
I'm working on it!
We'll work faster, would you? Won't be long before those things outside figure out where we went. You know they can smell blood.
Lady, I ain't the one who's bleeding. Lee, instead of just standing there like a goddamn mute, maybe you could give us a hand here?
Do you think the dead people saw us come back here? Are they going to find us?
No, they didn't see us. We were too fast for them.
I can still hear them out there. It sounds like they're getting closer.
It's just your imagination.
I'll feel safer when we're inside the house.
How's he looking?
I'm all right.
You're not all right. You've reopened your wound, you're losing blood, and God only knows what might have gotten in there. It could be infected. It could be...
No offense, but you really need to work on your bedside manner.
She's just worried about you, man. Don't worry. We're gonna get you fixed up in no time. Just as soon as we're inside, okay?
Okay. Thanks, man.
Please go and help Kenny. We need to get him inside now.
I'm on it. Just sit tight.
Hey, I'm not going anywhere.
Looks like something was buried here. Just a doghouse. A shovel is never not useful. Ben. Think we can get in through one of these windows?
Man, I don't think so. Whoever owned this place had them all barred up.
Yeah, looks pretty solid. About what happened back there on the street?
I know. I don't know what happened. I just froze up. Hasn't that ever happened to you?
Just hear what I'm saying to you. You put that girl in danger again, it won't be walkers you have to worry about.
I hear you.
How do you think Kenny's holding up?
I don't know. It's like all he can think about is finding a boat.
He definitely doesn't want to talk about Katja and Duck, at least not with me.
Maybe we should just let him deal with it in his own way. I'm gonna go check things out.
All right.
You think maybe someone's still inside?
Nah, we'd have heard from him by now, all the racket we're making. But whoever was here did a pretty good job fortifying it. Nice place to hole up. We could just figure out how to get in.
How's it coming? Find a way in yet?
Door's locked up tight. Too heavy to force it without making a whole lot of noise.
Maybe there's a better way in.
Well, if there is, I ain't seeing it.
Hey, how you holding up, man?
Lee, I appreciate the interest, but I don't think talking about my feelings right now is gonna help us get inside this house. Maybe you should have a look around. See what you can find.
No way I'm gonna be able to bust through that. What's this? Looks like there's some kind of pet door here.
I tried it already. That's locked too.
Who the hell ever heard of a locked doggy door?
I have. My neighbor had one just like that. It's radio controlled. The dog wears a collar with a chip in it, so the door only opens when the dog gets close to it.
Well, shit. Every day's a school day.
All right, so where's the dog?
Hey, be careful. Digging up dead things isn't what it used to be, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I hear you.
What's buried down there?
Clementine, honey, come sit with me in Omid. Let Lee work.
Oh, God, the smell.
I can't get it off.
Okay, that is not cool.
Are you okay?
I'm fine, honey. It's just the smell.
Are you sure you're...
I said I'm fine, okay?
Nothing.
Yes! God damn!
You see anything in there?
No. Looks like it's been empty a while.
Whatever you're gonna do, do it fast.
Okay, let me see if I can reach up in there.
Be careful, man.
No good. I can't get it.
Here, let me try. I think I can...
Clem, what do you see in there?
Ta-da!
Good work, Clem. But don't go shooting off like that without asking first, okay?
I was just trying to help.
I know, and you did good. You just had me worried there for a minute.
Can we maybe have this conversation inside? My leg's starting to hurt like hell.
Looks okay from here. Everybody in.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm good.
feel better already just being off my feet. Thanks, babe.
So, when were you gonna tell us about the radio?
Tell you what?
That it's working. That there's someone else on the other end of that thing. You didn't think that might have been worth sharing with the rest of us?
I was gonna tell you. Kenny and I only found out yesterday.
So both of you were keeping it from the rest of us. Great.
Who gives a shit about the damn radio? I'm more worried about whoever it was out there ringing that bell and bringing the dead down on top of us. It's like they didn't want us to make it to the river.
What makes you think it's not the same person? Whoever was on the radio was close enough to see us in the street, and we didn't see anyone else other than the guy in the bell tower.
Because that doesn't make a lick of damn sense. Why would they bring out the dead like that and then try to warn us about it?
How much sense does anything make anymore? In case you haven't noticed, there's a lot of twisted folks out there these days. At least the dead don't play games with you.
We need to make sure Chuck is okay. Once it's quieted down outside, we'll all head towards the river. See if we can find him. Deal?
Suit yourselves, but I'm not gonna wait around too long for someone else to grab up those boats. That's our ticket out of here.
Place seems secure, at least.
I'll feel better when we know that for sure. We need to check the whole house.
All right, fine. You and me will take the upstairs. Lee, you've got down here. Make sure you check every door, understand?
Okay.
Is there anything I can do?
Thanks, I got it. Hang out with Krist and Omid until I get back, okay?
Lee, I'm sorry.
What for?
Going through the door like that without checking first? I guess that was pretty dumb, huh?
Just ask me first the next time you're gonna outsmart all the grown-ups, okay?
Okay.
I should finish checking the house before heading back outside. All empty. Nothing. Water's off. No power. Cleaned out. Hope we never get desperate enough for food that this starts looking appetizing. I'm not that hungry. Besides, I need to finish checking the downstairs.
What happened?
It's nothing. Just, nothing. Exactly. My style. Hey, guys.
How's the house looking?
Not done searching the first floor yet, but so far, so good. How's that couch treating you, Omid? Leg feeling better yet?
I'm all right.
I feel you. Finding this house was a hell of a stroke of luck.
I'll like it a lot better when we know for sure it's safe.
I'll make sure. But right now it feels like just the break we needed. Maybe our luck's starting to turn around.
I'd like to believe that. Really, I would.
What do you guys think about this plan of Kenny's?
The guy's losing it. Look, Lee, I know he's your friend and all, but you need to be careful. That man is on the edge, and I don't know if I want to be around when he goes over it.
Kenny's solid. He's just been through a lot, that's all.
I hope you're right. For all our sakes.
Sit tight. I'll keep checking the first floor to make sure it's safe.
Thanks, Lee.
Holding up okay?
I hope this house is safe. Have you checked all the rooms to make sure?
No, but I'll take care of it. Whoever cleared this place out left behind two bottles of whiskey. Looks like someone didn't have their priorities straight.
How's it coming?
Looks expensive and heavy. Doubt any looters would be able to haul that thing too far. Must have stopped working a while ago. Nothing hiding in here. Just one more to check. That's the last room. Looks like downstairs is secure. Well, place ain't got much. We should be okay here for a while. At least until it quiets down outside.
Good. Thanks.
Is he okay?
Yeah, for now. But I'm really worried his leg might have gotten infected. Don't suppose you turned up any meds while you were poking around?
Nah, just dog food. And there's some whiskey in the back.
I was just asking Clementine if she knows who the man on her radio is. It's okay, honey. You can tell us. Who is he? What does he want?
Go ahead, Clem. It's okay. You're not in any trouble.
It's just a friend. I don't think he wants to hurt us.
What has he been saying to you? What have you been saying to him?
I told him I was trying to find my parents and that they were in Savannah. He really seems nice. I think he wants to help me find them.
Clementine, honey, trust me, that's not what he wants. He...
Lee? Lee, you need to get up here now.
What's wrong?
It's Kenny. Kenny said he thought he heard something up there. Went to go look.
He's up there?
I can't get him to come down.
Stay here. Kenny? Kenny, you okay, man? Oh, Jesus. What the hell is that? Oh, my God.
Like Duck, don't he?
It's just a kid. What the hell happened to him?
Ain't nothing on him. Guess he must have been hiding out up here. Starved to death.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know if I can do it, Lee. Not
Not again.
I can't ask you to go through this again. Let me take care of it.
Are you sure?
I guess we'll find out. This must have been where he slept. What a way to live. What a way to die. Just ran out of food, like we almost did. Like we still might. All empty. He probably died of dehydration before he starved. Damn. Poor kid. Must have tried to hide out up here until he starved to death. Well, this could have been Clementine if I hadn't found her when I did.
We should bury him.
I'll take care of it.
What's going on?
I saw someone standing there by the fence, watching us.
A walker?
No, too fast. Took off like a bat out of hell when I spotted him.
Was it a man or a woman?
Didn't get a good enough look.
What does it matter?
I'm wondering if it's the same guy who's been following us. The guy on the radio.
Kenny?
I'm fine. I'm fine. What's all the ruckus?
Lee saw someone watching us from outside the gate.
What? Who?
I can't be sure. They ran off before I could get a good look.
I don't like this one bit. Not one bit.
Me either. Walkers are one thing, but the thought of someone out there actually stalking us.
All right, that's it. We've stuck around here long enough. It's time to get back on track. Time to get down to the river and find ourselves a boat.
I don't know if Omid's well enough to move yet.
Well, he better get ready, because I'm going down to River Street right now to find a boat. And as soon as she's ready to go, we're moving out.
I don't know if it's safe to leave just yet.
Why the hell not? Walkers look to have cleared out.
That's not all I'm worried about.
So you'd rather just hunker down here and just let whoever's out there keep us boxed in, wait for them to starve us out? No thanks.
I hate to say it, but Kenny's right. Omid's not in great shape to move, but we can't do anything for him here. Without meds or a doctor, he's only gonna get worse.
All right, all right. I'll head to the river with Kenny to scope out a boat, while you get Omid ready to move.
What about me?
You'll stay here with the group. You'll only slow us down.
Wait, can't I come? My mom and dad can't be far now. Maybe we can look for them on the way to the river.
We need to focus on finding a boat right now, Clem. Like we talked about on the train, remember?
Okay.
Daylight's burning. Gonna go grab my gear, then we'll head out.
Come on, Clem. Let's go see if Omid needs anything.
So, you're just gonna leave me on the bench here?
That's not how it is, Ben. I need you to stay here and keep an eye on Clementine.
I can do that.
Well, just so we're clear, while I'm gone, anything or anyone tries to get inside this house, you shoot them. Don't even think twice about it. Understand?
I got no problem shooting walkers.
Did you hear what I said? Anything or anyone? Good.
Son of a bitch. That bastard's fucking with us again. It's another trap.
No, listen. That's not the same bell as before. This one's further off. Whatever it is, it's gonna get the dead moving over there.
What in the hell is going on?
The person ringing that bell might be doing us a favor.
Whatever, man. I find whoever's doing that, I'll ring their motherfucking bell for them.
Good one.
Let's keep moving.
Still nothing moving behind us. I think we're... About that? Doesn't look like it to me. Maybe we need to start thinking about a plan B.
This is the plan! It's the only one we've got, and you pissing on it in front of everyone like you did back at the house ain't exactly helping. Screw you. I ain't giving up that easy.
This one might still be salvageable. I'll check it out. You look further along the waterfront. Maybe there's something at the other end.
I don't think we should split up too far.
We don't have to. See that telescope? You can see all the way along the waterfront from right here. See what you can find.
Okay. Not exactly a welcome banner. Great. Needs a quarter to work. Some kind of warning? We'll do something like this. What the hell are these markings? They're all over the place. Hello, beautiful. Empty. Yeah, that would have been too easy. Someone already looted the place. Someone must have been trying to back their boat into the water. Only things didn't go as planned. You got a quarter on you?
Don't have a lot of use for small change these days. Maybe you can find one on the street somewhere.
Damn. Built solid. What's up with the boat?
It ain't gonna work. Hull's cracked beneath the waterline, plus someone stripped out the battery.
You can't fix it?
What the hell is that?
A fate worse than death. abandoned, like every other place in this city. No way that one's salvageable. No sign of any boots down there. The Talmadge Memorial Bridge. Can't imagine how many people tried to escape across it when the city started to fall. Nothing but water, not a boat to be seen. What the hell? Get down! Get down!
Why the hell are we hiding?
Someone came down from that building at the end of the street.
Where'd he go?
Saw him run into that newsstand.
Could be our bell ringer. How about we go find out?
We didn't come here looking for trouble.
Yeah, well, it seems to have a way of finding us anyways. Look, this could be the guy from the radio. The one who's been messing with us. If he is, we can put an end to it. Right now. Okay, you head up the middle of the street. I'll go around the side, cover your flank. We'll come up on him quiet, take him by surprise.
We just want to talk to this guy.
Oh, we're gonna talk.
You're not from Crawford.
You're not the guy on the radio.
I'm not a guy at all. Full marks for observation. Who the hell are you people?
I asked you first.
The name's Molly.
Molly? I'm Lee. This is Kenny and Clementine. We're not looking for any trouble.
Hi.
You guys really aren't from Crawford, are you?
I don't even know what that is.
Everything beyond that barricade.
What the hell happened here?
You sure you want to know? When everything started going to shit, some people got together and sealed off that whole neighborhood. Folks willing to do anything to stay alive, stop the dead getting in. I try to avoid them.
Why?
Let's just say they have a zero-tolerance policy for anyone who won't or can't live by their rules.
So how'd you know we weren't them?
Because there are no children in Crawford. Not anymore.
Do
you know who's been ringing those bells all over town?
Yeah, that would be me.
I knew it! Lee, I knew she was the one who's been following us! Fucking with us!
Get that finger out of my face, Grandpa, before I jam it straight up your ass. I haven't been following you. I don't even know who the hell you people are.
Calm down, Kenny. The voice on the radio was a guy, remember?
Yeah, well, whoever you are, ringing those bells this morning nearly got us all killed. Raised the dead all around us.
That's the idea, genius. It's how I get around. I ring a bell in one neighborhood to attract the local geeks towards it. Buys me some time to scavenge the areas they cleared out.
Geeks? Is that what you call them?
Yeah, you know, like at the carnival? They'll eat anything, alive or dead.
That's pretty smart, the bells.
Doesn't take much to outsmart the dead. Bunch of dumbasses. You just gotta move fast, get in and out before they start to wander back again.
Clem, what the hell are you doing here? How'd you get out of the house?
Well, Meade started getting really sick. Krista and Ben had to take him upstairs. I didn't just want to sit around there, I wanted to come help.
I told you we didn't need any help.
Really? Because if it weren't for her showing up when she did, I would have beaten your brains out.
That's debatable.
Uh-huh.
What do you mean, no children? Why not?
No children, no elderly, no one with an advanced medical condition. Basically, no one who might be a burden on the community. Crawford's all about the survival of the fittest. That's how they survived, while the rest of the world went to shit around them.
Jesus Christ.
Well, just the opposite, when you think about it.
That's not how our group does things.
You're not saying they actually... I mean, kids?
No, the children, they just forced to leave. Along with their parents. Left them to fend for themselves out here in the world.
Why?
Like I said, zero tolerance. Crawford got rid of anyone that couldn't pitch in, pull their own weight. The way they looked at it, those people were just a lot of useless mouths to feed. A drain on their precious resources.
How do you know all this?
Everyone in Savannah knew. What was going on inside Crawford got passed around like a ghost story. Except this one was true. Look, I'm gonna ask you people again. You're not from Crawford, so who the hell are you? What are you doing here?
Came down here looking for a boat. Hoping to get our people out of here. Find someplace safe.
Yeah, good luck with that. Anyone with a boat took it out of here as soon as people started eating each other. Any that got left behind, Crawford stripped them for parts. Cars, too.
There's gotta be something.
If there was, do you think I'd still be here? I've been over every inch of this city. This whole place is picked clean.
God damn it! Fuck!
Hey, moron. You wanna keep your voice down?
Shit.
Since you're not getting on any boat, I'd advise you folks to go back to where you came from before... Great. Just great.
Isn't that the...
way we came?
Fuck. Gunshot must have brought him back.
Isn't there another way back to the house?
Mom, is there a... Is there another way out of here?
Don't know, don't care.
So what the hell are we supposed to do?
I refer you to my previous answer.
But you have to help us, please!
Come on, make it fast!
Oh, fuck me!
Come on, hurry!
Come on!
Come on, man. One good jerk.
No!
Get your ass out of there! Gah!
open.
Here, use that to pry it open.
Clementine, can you hear me? If you can hear me, just get back to the house, okay? I'll meet you there. Shit. Feel solid. It's a drainage pipe. Good thing I'm out here and not in there. Seems loose. Shit. Won't tell me anymore. Won't go anymore in that direction. Don't turn no more in that direction.
Thank you.
Oh my god. Chuck, he must have tried to hide out down here. Poor bastard. No bullets. He must have saved the last one for himself. You deserve better, old man.
Who are you?
It's all right. It's okay. I don't want any trouble.
Neither do we. Which is why you'd do well to turn around and leave right now.
Look, I'm sorry I disturbed you folks. I'll just be going.
You can't let him leave. He's from Crawford. If he goes back there and they find out we're down here...
Are you from Crawford? They don't lie to me. I'll know.
Where else can he be from? Everywhere else around here is dead.
I'm not from around here. I'm from Athens. Grew up in Macon.
I have a brother in Macon. You were there? How was it? As bad as here?
I'm sorry.
You can't trust him, Vernon. You can't let him leave.
What do you want me to do? Shoot him in the head?
Why not? Be more of a mercy than anyone from Crawford ever showed us. Think, Vernon. What do you think they'll do if they find out we're down here, right under their feet?
Damn it. You're right. I'm sorry, friend. Can't take the risk.
I'm not from Crawford, but I saw what they did up there. It made me sick. I'm not like them, and I don't think you are either. I think you're a good man.
Keep back, or I swear I'll shoot.
It's all right. It's okay.
Vernon, what the hell are you doing? Vernon!
Relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
You're really not from Crawford?
No, I'm really not.
Well, we are, or were. We got out of there when they started sealing up the place. You know, started weeding out the sick and the old so that perfect survivor society wouldn't be threatened. No room for weakness or vulnerability in their little master race.
You don't look that old, so you're sick?
We're sick. We're all members of a cancer survivors group that used to meet here at the hospital. We're in remission. But that wasn't good enough for Crawford. They'd already rounded up five of us before the rest of us managed to hole up and hide from them down here. This old basement's been abandoned for years.
What is this? A morgue?
Yeah. Irony's always high on my list when I'm looking for a place to survive. How did you find your way down here?
A few of us got boxed in by walkers up on the street. Came down here trying to get away. Now I just want to get out of here and get back to my own people.
Well, that sewer system you came through runs all over the city. It'll take you wherever you want to go.
Those sewers are like a damn maze. Any chance you could help me find my way back?
Look, I'd like to help you, but we've all got our own problems. Two of our group are sick and need constant care, and I'm the only doctor here.
Besides, why should we help you?
Look, sorry if I scared you. I just want to get back to my people. Back to Clementine.
She's your daughter?
Yeah. She's probably already wondering where I am.
Well, we can't have that, can we?
Fern, what the hell are you doing?
It's all right, Bree. I had a daughter, too. Lost her in the first days. I'll be damned if I'll just sit back and let that happen to someone else.
We need you here.
Don't worry. I'll be back before you know it. Let's go see about your daughter.
Clementine? Clem? Molly?
Oh, hey, you made it back.
Who's this?
He didn't tell you about me? Understandable, I guess. I'm the one who put that beating on him when he tried to jump me back at the river. Who's the fossil?
Where's Clementine?
She's around here somewhere. Relax. I got her and Kenny both back safely. You're welcome, by the way. I think you have something that belongs to me.
Lee, thank God you're back.
Krista, what's wrong?
It's Omid. He's gotten worse. Much worse.
We have a man wounded.
Who's this?
This is Vernon. He's a doctor.
Oh, thank God.
Could you take a look at him?
You have to help us. Please.
I'll see what I can do. Take me to him.
Omid, honey. You're gonna be all right. Lee brought a doctor.
All right, let's take a look at him. I work better without an audience. Why don't you go find your little girl?
Clementine. Clementine? Clementine, you in here? Where is she? Clementine? Clem, you in here? Drawings, but where is she? Don't see her anywhere out there. No walkers either, though. Clementine, you here? Hello? What are you doing?
Just poking around.
You won't find anything. We already searched the place.
You'd be surprised what people miss. Trust me, I've been doing this for a while.
Where's Clementine?
Don't ask me, I'm not her keeper.
Hey, do I look like I'm in the mood to be jerked around? Where did she go?
Last I saw, she was downstairs with your redneck friend and that college kid who hangs around with him. Why don't you go bug them?
Don't see her out there. Clem? Clementine? Clementine! Come out, please! Kenny?
Oh, hey, you made it back. Good job. Good job.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
What does it look like?
Where'd you get the bottle?
Found it. You wanna throw down again like back on the train? Cause I fight better when I'm shit-faced. What the hell you looking at?
Getting wasted's not gonna help anyone.
Yeah? Well, what is? We are fucked! Molly said there's not a single boat left in Savannah. No way out. We got walkers all around us, that crazy fuck on the radio messing with us. Hell, if now ain't the time for a drink?
Clementine, where are you? Clementine? Clementine! Covered in vines. Don't think anyone came in through there. What the hell happened back here? Omid's doing okay?
As well as can be expected under the circumstances. I did what I could for him. Cleaned out the wound, but he's got a real infection. Running a fever. Without antibiotics, I...
Will you quit pacing? You're making everyone nervous.
Why are you even still here?
Hey, if your friend really can get that boat working, you're taking me with you as payment for saving your asses. I figure that's fair enough, don't you?
Well?
You want the good news or the bad news?
Let's get the bad news out of the way first.
Bad news is, she's not taking us anywhere the shape she's in right now. Gas tank's empty and the battery's dead.
So what's the good news?
That's it. That's all she needs. Some gas and a battery. Other than that, she's good to go.
Well, how are we supposed to get that stuff?
We should go back out on the street, see what we could find.
That's not gonna work. Crawford took everything and brought it inside their walls. They siphoned every gas tank, stripped every battery. There's nothing left out there. You saw that for yourselves.
She's right.
Well, what about this Crawford place? Sounds like they'd have everything we need. Maybe we should try there.
Now hold on a minute.
Surely we have to try. If there are people left in this city who are still alive, who still have supplies, what harm can it do to ask?
Trust me, you don't know these people. I do. You showing up with a wounded man, might as well put a noose around his neck. They don't exactly welcome children with open arms either.
What the hell kind of a place are we talking about here?
The worst kind? But I don't see what other choice we have.
And just how exactly do you figure we do this? Because from what I've heard, that place ain't exactly friendly to outsiders.
There's got to be some way we can sneak in there undetected.
There might actually be a way. I know the sewer system that runs beneath Crawford like the back of my hand. Y'all wouldn't happen to have a map by any chance?
Yeah, actually.
I think I could lead us through so we could pass under the perimeter and right into the center where they keep their supplies. We come up right underneath them, take them by surprise, grab what we need, and get out before they even knew what hit them.
That's actually not the worst idea I've ever heard. I mean, it's close, but I don't know. Maybe it could work.
I've thought about it before, just never had the people to do it. But I think if we all work together, we could pull it off.
And what do you want in return for all this help you're giving us?
Crawford doesn't just have what you need for your boat. They're also well stocked with medical supplies. Medicine that my people could use, just as yours could.
We can do this. We have to.
So, it's decided then? We're going to Crawford?
We can do this. I know it.
Hell yeah, we can.
Are we seriously talking about this? I mean, what about the risk?
I don't know about you, kid, but I'd rather take a chance on doing something than just sitting around here waiting to die. That boat out there is an answered prayer. Just gotta push a little bit farther. Are you in or out?
We should go tonight, under cover of dark. I'll go let my people know. Give you all a chance to prepare. I'll be back before midnight.
Be careful.
That's how I'm still alive.
I told you to stay in your room. How long have you been there?
Is it going to be dangerous?
Is what going to be dangerous?
Crawford.
I can't lie to you, Clem. Yeah, it's going to be dangerous. But it's the only way to get the things we need to make Omid better and get the boat working. That's why we have to do this. Do you understand?
I don't want anyone else to die.
Neither do I, Clem, but sometimes we have to take that kind of risk.
I guess I should go get ready.
Say what now?
You said you'd need all of us to do this, and you said I'm a big help, remember? Molly said Crawford is the only place left in Savannah that still has people. That means it must be where my mom and dad are, right?
I don't think I'll find them at Crawford, Sweet Pea.
Why not?
Because they're good people. And Crawford is a bad place run by bad people. I don't think they would have stayed in a place like that.
How do you know they're good if you've never met them?
Well, they raised you, didn't they?
Can't I come with you?
No. I'm sorry.
Check out what I found in the garage. Hatchet, hacksaw, some other tools. Might come in handy on this little break-in.
Nice.
Can I talk to you a minute?
What's up?
I took another look at the boat. She's a 30-footer.
So?
So, we're gonna have a capacity problem. Boat that size ain't gonna hold more than 5 people. Even with one of them a kid.
Me, you, Clem, Krista, Omi, Ben, Molly.
Assuming everyone makes it back alive, that's still one too many. Even if we cut Molly loose. Before this is over, we're gonna have to make a decision.
You're not serious.
Look, I'm just saying, if we want the best chance of... Who the hell is this?
This is Bree. She can help us.
Good. We're gonna need all the help we can get.
I was a student at the school where Crawford keeps their supplies. I know the layout.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's get moving.
Hold up just a sec. You understand why you have to stay behind, don't you?
I guess.
Plus, you have a job to do. An important job. I need you to stay here and watch over the house. Watch over Omid.
What should I do if something happens while you're gone?
Here, I want you to take this. You remember how to use it, don't you? It's just like I showed you.
I remember.
So if anyone tries to get inside the house that isn't one of us, or if something does happen to Omid...
I know what to do.
Let's get you inside. Let's get this over with.
This should be it. We're right underneath the center of Crawford. The old school should be directly above us.
Okay, people. This is it. Remember the plan. We stay quiet. We stay hidden, and we stay together. We find what we need, and we get the hell out before anyone even knows we're there. Got it? Can't get a good look above with the cover on. Let's go.
Where is everybody? There should be guards patrolling.
What? Are you disappointed?
It's just strange, is all.
I think I see one. Over there by the door.
Okay. Me and Kenny will sneak up, try to take him out quiet. The rest of you wait for our signal, then follow us over. Everybody got it? Okay, Kenny, let's do this quiet. No shooting unless there's no other choice.
Right behind you.
Walker doing inside here? Get inside, fast!
you think they saw us?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Shit!
What the hell happened here? I thought this place was supposed to be secure!
What always happens, I guess. In the end, the dead always win.
Oh man, we are so screwed.
No, this is good.
Vernon's right. We can deal with walkers easier than armed guards.
I agree. So long as we don't let them box us in, we can still do this. The plan hasn't changed.
The plan hasn't changed? Every time walkers show up, the plan changes. Do you even have any idea how many of them are out there?
No. You want to do a head count? Or do you want to get what we need and get the hell out of here? Come on, I think I know which way to head.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Just keep moving.
Here.
Looks okay. Everybody in. Figures.
Looks like they were using this room as some kind of command center.
Okay, so now what? Where do we start looking?
Here. Just give me a sec.
Where would be the best place to look for medicine?
Right here. Nurse's station. They were using it as a medical facility.
How do you know that?
Just makes sense, doesn't it?
Any idea where we could find a battery?
Maybe at the auto shop. There used to be one in the alley outside the fire escape.
Yep, it's called Herman's. You can't miss it.
What about the fuel? Where should I start looking?
There's a maintenance shed across from the playground here. If they were storing fuel, that's probably where it'll be.
Okay, I'll make the run to the maintenance shed for the fuel.
It'll be faster if I go with you. I can take you right to it.
I'll come too.
No, two people's enough. You stay here, see if you can use any of those tools we brought to get that armory door open. We might need to shoot our way out of here.
I'll go for the medicine.
I'll come with you. I know what to take.
Okay. Guess that leaves me to go find us a battery.
I'll go with you. Watch your back.
Okay, we've got a plan. Everyone be careful. Stay close to one another. We'll all meet back here. Good luck. Looks like they had quite a system here. Crawford's final solution. Hey, You need any help with that?
Thanks, I got it. Just once, I'd like to do something useful, you know?
Well, I'll let you get on with it.
No, wait. There is something you can help me with. Something that's been on my mind. I could use your opinion.
What is it?
It's Kenny. Since I've been helping him work on the boat, I've gotten to know him a little better. He's a good guy, you know? And it's eating me up knowing what I know. I've been thinking about telling him the truth.
Ben, come on. This again?
It's my fault Duck and Katja got killed. If I hadn't screwed up back at the motor inn, they'd still be alive. How am I supposed to just carry something like that around? I have to tell him. I guess you've got your own problems. Look, don't worry about it. I'll figure it out. I'm gonna get back to this.
Must be the guy who ran this place. Looks like he figured himself as some kind of supreme leader.
The alleyway to the auto shop's down here. You coming or not?
I've already been fired. They're worthless. Open it without the combination. This must be the door to the alleyway where the auto shop is. Where the hell is Molly? Molly, you out here? Guess I'm not going that way. Damn, it's jammed tight. Better not get too close.
He's mine.
Molly? Molly!
What?
I think you got him.
One more!
He's wearing medical scrubs. Some kind of scientist or doctor, maybe?
Yeah, well, he ain't shit now. Did you find us a way in?
Yeah, but the garage door's jammed. Can't raise it.
Molly? Not a problem. Look what I found.
Oh yeah, that'll work.
Take a look around. I'll make sure no stragglers get under this door.
Well, I can see where the battery should be, but it's not.
Perfect.
That blinking. Must be an anti-theft system. Good chance of a working battery being in that car, if I can find a way to get up there. It's locked. No way in. No power. Looks like it's the hose for the lift hydraulics. Don't think I can pry that hose apart with just my hands. Maybe if I had something to cut it with.
Something you need?
What was all that about back there?
He came at me up on that rooftop. Tried to take a bite out of me, so I took care of business. What, you got a problem with me killing geeks?
No. It just seemed like you went to town on him a little more than you needed to.
Hey, you never really know when those things are all the way dead. I was just making sure. Look, you want to get this battery or not? Time's wasting.
What do you think happened to Crawford?
Don't know, don't care. As far as I'm concerned, these fuckers got what was coming to them.
Not a lot of sympathy for all the people who died here, huh?
I have about as much for them as they did for the sick and the old and anyone else they didn't think was fit to belong in their little paradise. So yeah, fuck 'em.
Think I can borrow that, hook thing of yours?
I don't know. Hilda and I have been through a lot together.
Hilda?
That's what I call her. Don't judge.
Please, can I borrow Hilda? I'll take good care of her. She won't get a scratch.
I got your promise now. Not a scratch.
I did it.
Whoa!
That's probably not good.
No shit!
I'll try to hold him off. Hurry!
There's the battery. Finally, something goes right. Got that one off. The positive terminal still bolted on. It's off. Got it.
Yeah, but we still got a problem here. Put it in here. I'll carry it. Okay, follow me. Move your ass.
Great. Now what?
Skylight.
Okay, so now we're on a roof.
Do you ever stop complaining? Come on. Come on, what are you, chicken? Jump!
Come on.
Later. Something I gotta do first.
What?
Catch you later.
Wait, you've still got the battery?
Yeah, I think I'll hold on to it. Make sure you don't leave without me. See you back in class.
Molly! God damn it, what the hell is she doing? You guys need any help?
Thanks, but I think we're almost in.
We're taking care of it, Lee. Don't worry.
You sure you two don't need any help?
We're taking care of it, Lee. Don't worry.
Other just yet. Let's get the hell back to the classroom. Give us a hand with these fuel cans. They weigh a goddamn ton.
Hey, how'd you guys make out?
We got the fuel.
Awesome. Good job, guys.
How you doing with that door?
Not so good.
Here, let me give you a hand. Did you get that battery yet?
Yeah, Molly has it. She should be back here soon.
She'd better be.
What do we still need?
We already got the fuel and the battery. Once we find some medicine, we'll be good to go.
So where's this battery you found?
Molly has it. She ran off to do something.
Well, she'd better bring it back here. I don't know why you trusted that girl with it. We hardly know her.
She saved your life, didn't she?
Yeah, but what has she done for me lately?
Bree?
Hey, Lee. Thanks for all your help back there. I don't think we would have made it without you.
No problem. We're all on the same team. How long have you known Vernon?
Couple of years. He ran our support group. He was really great, helping me come to terms with my disease. But how do you come to terms with something like this? With a place like Crawford? I don't know what I or the other survivors would have done without Vernon. He's the one who held us together, kept us alive.
So you're a cancer survivor, like Vernon and the others?
Yeah, I was diagnosed when I was in college. Been getting treatment ever since. Just when I was starting to get better, when I thought there might be some hope, all this happened. Lost my whole family. I'm the only one who survived. Funny how things work out, huh?
What do you think about this whole Crawford situation?
I'd rather not talk about it. Too many awful memories. Even being back here gives me a bad feeling.
Even now, with everyone dead?
I got no sympathy for what happened to these people. They weeded out the sick and the old, even children, those least able to defend themselves so that they could save their own skins. Whatever happened here, however Crawford fell, I consider it poetic justice.
Damn, girl, that's cold.
It's how I feel. If you'd seen what I seen, you'd feel the same. I'm a little busy here, Lee. Maybe you should go get that battery or help with the medicine.
They wandered into the hallway after we got inside. I think they must have heard us rooting around in here. The whole place is infested. They're everywhere.
Calm down. I took care of them. What about the meds? Did we find what we need?
Yeah, that's our other problem. Take a look. Looks like they were keeping all the prescription meds in that safe, locked up tight.
There's no way we can bust it open?
Maybe with enough time, but I don't know how much of that we have. Be a hell of a lot quicker if we just knew the four-digit combination.
Well, I doubt they just wrote it down and left it here for us to find. We should just try busting it open. We don't have any other choice.
Okay, you get started. I'll take a look around, see if I can find anything useful. Anna Correa. Guess she must have been a patient here. And what's this? How's it coming?
Slow. Too slow. I'm worried that by the time we manage to get this thing open, it may be too late.
Hey, Doc. I just wanted to thank you for coming with us. And for all your help. I really appreciate it.
Don't mention it. It's times like these we've got to help each other the most, right? And we're no better than those Crawford sons of bitches.
I heard that. Molly helped me get the battery we needed.
That's great. One down. Where is she?
She took off. Had some kind of errand she needed to run.
Took off? With the battery?
Yeah. Don't worry. She'll be back.
I hope so. That girl doesn't really strike me as a team player. More the mercenary kind.
How much time do you think Omid has, Doc?
You want my medical opinion? The sooner we get him some strong antibiotics to start fighting that infection, the better. Let's just leave it at that, huh?
I'll go see if I can find something that'll help us get that safe open.
Good idea.
There's dried blood on this printout, and on the floor. Looks like a trail of it from the safe to the camera over there, then out the door. What the hell happened here? What's this on the floor?
It's a sonogram.
Hey, Krista.
Yeah?
Are you feeling okay?
I'm fine. Why are you asking me that?
It's just that you've been looking a little pale the past couple of days. You've been throwing up.
Oh, come on! You just dug up a rotting dog carcass! I'm surprised we weren't all throwing up. Lee, I'm fine. Quit worrying about me, okay? Worry about Omid. We've got to get him these meds.
Are you making any progress with the safe?
No. Without the combination, I don't know how we're going to get this damn thing open. If we don't get back to Omid with some medicine soon...
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I hope I did the right thing leaving Clementine back at the house.
What else were you going to do? Bring her on a dangerous mission?
I know. Just want her to be safe.
Why shouldn't she be?
No offense, Krista, but Omid's pretty sick. If he dies with Clementine alone in the house with
That is not going to happen. Do you hear me? That is not going to happen. We're going to get these meds to Omid, and he's going to be fine. He's going to be fine!
You're right. I'm sorry.
Look, Lee, I just want to get back to Omid. Let me do my thing, all right?
Okay. Already cleaned out. Y'all already checked these drawers?
Yes, Lee. Nothing in there worth taking.
Just a bunch of papers. No safe combination, though. What is this? A copy machine. Not that it matters with no power around here. Do you think shooting it open would work?
Only thing that would accomplish is getting us all killed. So, no, I don't.
Looks pretty sturdy. No way we're gonna force that open.
We might be able to find something to pry it open, but it'll take time.
We don't have time. Omid needs that medicine. We have to get it open now.
Vernon, Krista, come look at this.
This is day 82 since the outbreak. 1547, Dr. Logan in consultation with patient Anna Correa.
Why are you recording this?
Regulations. Oberson has ordered me to keep records of all medical examinations and consultations. I need you to brace yourself, Anna. The sonogram confirms that you're pregnant.
Oh God, oh God, oh God.
As you know, the rules are very clear. The termination is mandatory.
You don't have to tell them. Tell them it was just nausea. But you gave me something for it and it went away. This is my problem, not yours.
If Oberson finds out that I concealed evidence of a pregnancy, I'm sorry, but these are the rules. I'm going to give you a sedative. It'll make the procedure easier on you.
I don't want the procedure! I want my baby! I can't do this! I can't do this!
Anna, you don't have a choice. Now, if you like, you can take some time with this, but I need you to come back no later than tomorrow, or I'll have no choice but to inform Oberson myself. I'm sorry.
Damn it! We almost had it.
What the hell kind of place was this?
Like Molly said, the worst kind.
Lee, maybe there's another tape. We gotta keep looking.
I think I recognize that doctor. He was one of the walkers out in the alley by the auto shop.
Maybe you should search it. See what he's got on him.
This might be just what we need. And what's this? Looks like some kind of code. But Vernon said the safe combination was only 4 numbers. Shit, time to go. Found 2 more tapes. One of them is dated October 10th.
That's the day after the first one we watched.
Put it in.
Have you made a decision?
I thought you said I didn't have a choice.
Well, technically you do. You can terminate the pregnancy or leave Crawford. Of course, that would be a death sentence for both you and your unborn child.
Maybe that's best. I stayed up all last night thinking about this. Why are we even trying to survive? To keep on living? If this is what it takes? If this is what it's turned us into?
I don't make the rules, Anna.
Doctor, I'm begging you. Please help me.
Maybe one day, when things are different, you can try again. But for now, today, we have to do this. No. No. No.
I think we know what happened to Crawford.
More importantly, we got the combination.
Krista, are you all right? What's wrong?
It's nothing. That was just hard to watch. Don't worry about me. I'm fine.
All right. Let's get those meds and get the hell out of here.
We're in business. Antibiotics, morphine. We'll take as much of this as we can carry. Okay, I think we're good. This is more than enough for your people and mine. Let's go.
You know, I found a 3rd tape in a locker outside. Maybe there's something else on there.
We got the meds for Omid. That's all I care about.
We'll head back to the classroom. Don't take too long, Lee.
Listen, as fun as this was, I have to put a stop to this little arrangement. This is the last I can give you.
Why?
Oberson had someone down here yesterday taking inventory. He's really cracking down. I just can't risk it.
We had a deal.
Yes, we had a deal. We don't anymore.
My sister needs this medicine. Without it, she'll die, or she'll start showing symptoms and they'll take her away. I can't let that happen.
I'm sorry, Molly. I've done all I can, but I have to look out for myself here.
Yeah, that's the Crawford way, isn't it?
Well, shit. Christ! Oh, you scared the shit out of me. Where the fuck have you been?
Sightseeing.
I'll take that battery now.
Oh, Yeah, about that. I'm just kidding. Here you go.
What's that?
Nothing. So, are we done? Well, okay. Let's... What the hell?
I think that's our cue to get the hell out of here.
Whoa!
Jesus!
Shit!
Man.
Sorry. I just got spooked by those bells, and then I heard someone coming.
What the fuck are you doing out here?
Kenny and I still can't get the door open to the armory. He sent me out to look for something we can use to bust it open. I found this.
Ben? Where did you get that?
I just found it. It was stuck in the door handle at the end of the hallway back there.
Oh no.
Shit!
Thank me later. Come on! Ben, we gotta go! Ben! Move your ass!
What the fuck is going on?
They're coming.
Oh, shit.
That ought to hold them.
Sure, but now how do we get out?
Through the armory. We can just get this damn door open.
Come on, damn you!
This is my fault, all my fault.
What the hell's he babbling about?
Ben, we talked about this.
No, wait. I want to know what he meant. What do you mean this is all your fault?
Kenny, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, man.
Kid, this ain't the best time. Whatever you did, save it for later.
I opened the door. I let them in.
I said save it for after we get out of here.
It's been me all along, putting all of us in danger. Katja and Duck, it was all me. It was all me.
Wait a minute. What are you saying?
It was me who made the deal with the bandits at the Motor Inn, slipping them supplies. I thought maybe I could keep them off our backs. When it got discovered, that's when they attacked. And that's when Duck...
Kitty man, I agree with you. You should kick his ass. But now's not the time. Gotta focus on getting out of here!
You little pissant! You're fucking dead, you hear me? Dead! My wife and child, you gotta both fucking kill!
Kenny, listen to me. You can whip his skinny little ass later, but right now we gotta go!
Nice group you got here.
Not the time, Molly.
If this asshole thinks he's getting on my boat after what he did, he's out of his motherfucking mind!
Kenny, we'll sort this out later. After we get out of here, okay?
Ain't nothing to sort out. I just told you the way it's gonna be. The boat's not big enough for all of us. Somebody's gotta get left behind. Might as well be this piece of shit right here.
Well, I vote we leave him. I'm sorry, Ben. I know you mean well, but all I want to do is get back to Omid, and you put that at risk.
What about the rest of us? Don't we get a say?
Now can we go?
Damn right. Vernon, come on! So much for the armory.
What's left of it?
A few rounds. That's it.
You didn't close that door behind us?
I couldn't. The lock was busted.
Great. Just fucking great. Come on. There's gotta be a way out down here.
Ah!
not gonna hold. Back upstairs!
Lee, look!
Out of here?
This leads to the roof. We might be able to find a way down from there.
You didn't come into town from the railroad, did you?
Yeah. Why?
Never mind. I can see the sewer where we came in from here. I think we can do this.
Well, what are we waiting for? Go, go!
Yeah, come on, let's go!
Omid?
Clementine! Clementine!
You made it back!
Told you I would, didn't I?
Did you find my parents?
Her parents?
No, we didn't. Sorry, sweet pea. I looked for them, but no.
Clementine, what happened here?
One of those things got inside. It tried to get upstairs. I stopped it.
Upstairs? Omid!
You did good, kiddo. Real good. Hey, what do you say we go check on Omid? Krista? Everything okay?
Omid! I never should have left you. I'm so sorry.
Krista, get away from him.
Hey. Back already?
We got you medicine.
Good. Feel like I could use some. Where's Ben?
He didn't make it.
What happened?
Dumb son of a bitch nearly got us all killed. Lee stepped up and did what he had to. That's what happened.
Nice going, asshole.
What's eating you?
Yeah, I did what I had to. But I don't expect Clementine to understand that. Hell, I don't want her to understand it.
You did the right thing. Trust me, she'll understand. I'm gonna go start work on the boat.
Okay, with a little luck, you should start feeling better pretty soon. I'll stay here for a few more hours to check on him. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks, Doc.
Yes, thank you so much.
Maybe now's a good time for you and me to have a little talk in private.
Listen, man, about what happened to Bree.
Please, save your sympathy for someone who's buying it.
What?
You don't think by now I got you figured? You don't strike me as someone who has a lot of consideration for others. Look at what you did to get me to come here with you in the first place. You expect me to believe you give a shit that it wound up costing Bree her life?
Now, just hold on a damn minute. Listen!
No, you listen. You got some good people here, and they look to you as their leader. Well, I'm here to tell you, the kind of leader you are, they're not gonna make it much longer. And you're kidding yourself if you think putting them all on a boat is gonna solve anything. Now, you may not care about all of those people, but I know you care about that little girl. Which is why I'm gonna make you an offer.
What kind of an offer?
I'll take her off your hands, take her back with me, to my people. We're well supplied, well hidden, and a lot of us have had kids of our own. And now Crawford's fallen, we got nothing left to fear from them. She'll be safe with us. Safer than she will be if she stays with you, I promise you. That's what you want for her, isn't it? To be safe? I know it's a lot to consider, but I want you to think about some things. You chose to let that boy die back in Crawford. I gotta wonder about the morality of the kind of man who would do something like that. I got to wonder what kind of parent you'd be.
Hey, going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm about to head out. I just wanted to say thanks for everything. It's been fun.
So that's it? After all we've been through, you're just gonna leave?
Yeah, I figured you don't owe me anything. I got what I wanted in Crawford, and I never did like the water.
Where will you go?
I don't know. I'll figure it out when I get there.
What do you want me to tell the others?
Tell them whatever you want. I'm not real big on goodbyes. Tell Clementine she's going to be okay. You've got a good one there. She reminds me of me.
Hey, sweet pea.
Kenny's working on the boat.
I know.
What are we going to do after he fixes it? Where will we go?
Someplace else. Someplace better. Clem, honey, what's wrong?
What happened to Ben? What did Kenny mean when he said you did what you had to?
Clem. You have to believe me. I tried to save him, but Ben didn't want me to.
What do you mean?
What Ben did was very brave. He knew we were running out of time, and that saving him might put everyone else in danger. So he told me to leave him behind so the rest of us could get away. I know that's difficult to understand.
I understand.
You do?
Yeah, he thought about other people before he thought about himself. My mom always told me that's what makes a good person.
Well, she was right.
Before we leave tomorrow, will we have time to look for my parents?
I'd like to, Clem, but I don't think we'll have time. We really shouldn't stay here any longer. It's not safe. Clementine? 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 Clementine! Oh, God.
Are you crazy? What are you doing out here? It ain't safe.
Lee, where's Clementine? She's not in her room.
Vernon ain't in the house either. What the hell is going on?
Whose blood is that?
It's mine.
Oh my God.
No way. No, no fucking way.
There's no time to worry about me. Clementine's gone.
There's no chance she just wandered off on her own?
No way.
Then who the hell took her?
I don't know. Last night, Vernon came to me and offered to take her with him. Said she'd be better off.
Son of a bitch. I knew we couldn't trust that fucker.
Wherever she is, I have to find her.
Okay. What do you need from us?
Clem may not have much time. We have a better chance of finding her if we all go together. Who's with me?
We're all responsible for Clementine, and in your condition, you may not make it to her in time. She needs our help. All of our help.
Damn right. We can't let you do this alone.
So that's settled then. We'll look for Clementine together.
Thanks, you guys. appreciate it, really.
Lee, man, you know I care about Clementine, and I am a Christian man. And I keep asking myself, if this was me asking you for help, asking you to put your life on the line, would you be there for me? Because there have been plenty of times when you ain't been.
Kenny, you know what Clementine means to me. She's my family now. She's all I got.
Hell, in the end, family's all that matters. And you were there for Kachi and Duck when it mattered most, I guess. All right, I'm in.
Okay, guys, we should go find Vernon, see if he took her. Let's head out.
What about the boat? We just gonna leave it unguarded?
If someone was gonna take it, they'd have done it already. Besides, what choice do we have?
Where the hell are they?
Looks like they got out of here in a hurry.
Vernon! Get out here! There doesn't have to be any trouble here! All I want is the girl! Give her back and nobody needs to get hurt!
Are you all right? Where are you?
Vernon, you son of a bitch!
You got your tongue?